Martin, thank you very much indeed. Good evening. Assalamu alaikum. For the families of those who were murdered and for the survivors, and we have heard harrowing testimony this evening, the truth is no words of ours can ease the pain and the anger and the tears that they have to deal with. And for the rest of us, what did we feel at the time? What do we feel tonight? What should we feel? I'll tell you what I feel. Shame. Bitter, burning shame. And the question for all of us here is, what do we do with our shame when we hear of such horror and brutality and depravity in our continent? Why is bearing witness so important? Because bearing witness is the best way to ensure that we never forget. And never forgetting is the best way to try and ensure never again. It was Edmund Burke who said, "The only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men to do nothing." And the truth is, we did nothing. Now, here we are meeting in Britain, a country where we have brought, after a lot of struggle and difficulty, safety and security and justice and the rule of law to our citizens. And as I reflect, and I want to thank you, Eric, for making tonight possible, and Waka and all of those who've worked so hard to bring us here this evening, we can take that shame and work night and day to ensure that all of the citizens of the world ensure safety and security and justice and the rule of law. And we created at the end of the Second World War the instrument that was meant to do that, the United Nations. And it has done things in some places, and in others it has not. And when I listened to you, Hassan, I felt, we all felt, the reproach in your voice. And we understand why. And the truth is that we have to will action and we have to will the means. And as we look around the world at what happened in Srebrenica and what is happening today in some parts of the world, we have not yet created those means, have we? And it is every one of our responsibility to ensure that we do, so that all of the citizens of the world, no matter who they are, where they come from, what language they speak, what faith they profess, what clothes they wear, have the same rights, because we are all equal human beings. And there's one other thing that we can do, because Eric, you asked the question, and rightly so. As we reflect on what we saw in 1995, as we ponder on what we have listened to this evening, the question we ask ourselves time and time and time and time again is why? Why do human beings turn on their neighbours? How can human beings commit such crimes against their fellow men and women? And there's, you may think, well, I can't sort out the international humanitarian and peacekeeping system, but I tell you, there's one thing we can do wherever we live, whatever part of the world, whatever community, whatever country, is we can get to know one another. Because if we get to know one another, we come to understand that whatever the differences there appear to be between us that make the world such an extraordinary place, underneath those differences is a common humanity. And the more we get to know each other and live alongside each other and care for each other and love each other, better chance we have that never again will finally come.